Let's travel back in time together to 2017, when DeepL came out. You all know DeepL, right? It's based on a technology called neural machine translation, or to put it simple, AI-powered machine translation. This technology was a huge revolution back then. It was better than anything we'd seen before. And you know what else happened in 2017? I graduated. I just completed 5 long years at university to become a professional translator. And according to the media, translators were about to die out. Well, but don't worry. 6 years later, translators are still there and are still translating. Because when it comes to AI, hype often outstrips performance. The technology has not replaced translators, but extended their range of possibilities. And now they can choose, depending on the context, between 2 working strategies. Number 1, the tried and trusted human methods of using your own brain and a few dictionaries. And number 2, the hybrid method, which means asking a machine translation system like Google Translate or DeepL to translate the content before correcting and proofreading it to make sure it doesn't contain any errors or inaccuracies. This strategy saves time, therefore money, while still ensuring a high level of quality. And this is the method I'm interested in for my PhD. My main goal is to discover whether the use of this hybrid strategy impacts the linguistic properties of translated text. Does it affect the richness of the vocabulary, the sentence structure, the variety of connectives? In short, does the machine impose its own style, its fingerprint, on the translations it helps to produce? To answer this question, I'm gathering large data sets of translations from companies in Switzerland and abroad and carefully inspecting them for the tiniest differences between human and hybrid translations. But if we get to the same level of quality, then what's the point of knowing if German adverbial connectives are more or less varied when translated into English? Well, you might not be aware of it, but you are reading tons of translation every day. And everything we read, consciously or unconsciously, shapes the way we use the language in turn. So if machines do impose their style, however subtly, on the translations they help to produce, we will all eventually end up adopting machine style. And that would put the variety, color, and spontaneity of our own languages at risk. So, let's take today's clickbait headlines, heralding the death of intellectual profession, and focus instead on what makes us unique, brilliant, and creative human beings who can never be fully replaced by machines. Thank you.